Good afternoon. The federal government is pushing for an increase to the minimum wage as the cost of living continues to bite. Federal politics reporter Amanda Cobb joins us now from Canberra. Amanda, what can workers expect?
Mark, workers could be in for a pay rise, but only if the government gets its way. Labor will give its submission to the Fair Work Commission this week, saying any wage increase that's less than the rate of inflation will have a detrimental effect on workers. The current minimum wage is $23.23 an hour. If that amount rises at the current rate of inflation, it would increase to just over $24 an hour. That's an extra $38 per week for full-time workers. Now, while that might sound like a relatively small amount, business advocates say employers will struggle to pay. And the opposition says inflation should be the government's focus. But Labor shot back in a fiery question time this afternoon.
Ultimately, it's not government paying for it, it's small business that's paying for it. So it's very easy for government to adopt that posture. But in reality, it's the 2.5 million mum and dad small businesses who will need to find that additional funding.
The problem is, if you have that minimum wage rise and there is still inflation out there, it's simply going to be eaten up. That's why getting inflation under control is the only solution to people's cost of living crisis.
Don't pretend you can care about cost of living if you want people's wages held back. Those opposite want people to work longer for less. We want people to earn more and keep more of what they earn.
The decision ultimately rests with the Fair Work Commission, which is a body that's independent of government. But recently, Labor did have some wins on wages, with a big pay increase for aged care workers. But employees in the wider workforce will have to wait until June to find out if they're in for the same celebrations. Mark?
Amanda, thank you. Well, 19 people have been charged over a pro-Palestinian protest at Port Botany last night. Hundreds of activists were protesting the Israeli Zim shipping line and calling for a ceasefire in Gaza.
Any companies that are aligned with the Israel war machine should not be allowed in Australia.
The group were charged with obstructing the road, ignoring a move-along order and disrupting a major facility. Well, a body has been found during a search for a missing 26-year-old man at Darling Harbour. The man was last seen by his friends at 3:30 yesterday morning after he had been drinking at Bungalow 8 nightclub. Police had been searching from the air and on the water up until this morning. Well, the first of the suspects accused of carrying out a deadly terror attack at a Moscow concert hall have appeared in court. It comes as President Vladimir Putin lashes out at Ukraine, trying to link them to the gunmen. US correspondent Alison Petrowski has the details.
Well, the first two of four suspected gunmen have appeared in a Moscow courtroom today, blindfolded, hunched over and paraded in front of a waiting press pack. Once inside the courtroom, we saw one suspect held in a glass cage, and when his blindfold was removed, you could see that he had a black eye. Now, Russian state media says they have been charged, but at this point in time, they have not provided further details. ISIS says that these are their men. They've claimed responsibility multiple times over the weekend. However, Vladimir Putin is not connecting them to ISIS. Instead, he is trying to link these men to Ukraine. These are claims that Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky strongly refutes. So too do US officials, including US Vice President Kamala Harris. Hours after Putin made these baseless allegations, Russian forces unleashed a barrage of attacks on Ukrainian cities, including Ukraine's capital Kyiv. One Russian missile even violated Polish airspace. Poland's foreign ministry this morning demanding an explanation from Moscow, with fears that Putin will continue with his attacks on Ukraine in the days to come. The Kremlin this morning released these pictures of Vladimir Putin lighting candles in an undisclosed location, paying his respects to the victims. It is a national day of mourning in Russia, with many thousands taking to the street to show their grief, to pay respects to the victims, with that makeshift shrine outside the Crocus City Concert Hall continuing to grow hour upon hour.
ANZ will pay more than $57 million to its customers to settle a class action brought against it in 2021. The class action alleges some customers were charged interest on purchases that should have been interest-free on select personal credit cards sold between 2010 and 2018. You've probably heard of fire wardens. Well, in a sign of the times, small businesses are now looking towards the need for a cyber warden. A team of business leaders are teaming up with security experts to find out the best way to protect themselves. To talk about this issue, let's bring in Luke Achterstraat from the Council of Small Business Organisations Australia. Luke, thanks for your time. This new research shows 4 in 10 small businesses don't think they could properly handle a cyber attack on their company. That surely is a frightening prospect.
Look, that's exactly right, Mark. And the point of the research we've released today is to really shine a light on this issue. You know, cyber attacks are becoming increasingly common, and a lot of people in the community think it's something that only really the big end of town endure. You know, there's been some highly publicised cases like Medibank and Optus, but we certainly know that hackers are becoming more sophisticated, and they're actually targeting small businesses and looking for vulnerabilities. So as you said, 4 in 10 don't feel well equipped, and there's good reasons for that. You know, they're very time poor, our small businesses. This can become quite a complex area and quite a confusing area as well. So we're looking to demystify this process and really give them a bit of a crash course in what they can do to protect their small business from a cyber attack.
So this is happening quite frequently.
Almost 1 in 2 small business owners will have some sort of interaction with a cyber attack. And the research also confirmed that the average cost of a cyber attack to a small business is $50,000.
You flagged how widespread this is, but are enough small businesses taking the cyber threat seriously?
Mark, it's a great question. You know, the Cyber Wardens program is all about bringing people on that journey to really make them more cyber aware. So this program is about behavioural change. It's about raising awareness, and it's also about saying to small businesses, look, if you've had an attack, just reach out, put your hand up. Cyber Wardens is about a 45-minute online course designed for time-poor small business owners to give them that crash course, to bring them up to speed, and we hope to really get more conversations going around this.
Luke, you mentioned the course. Is there anything else businesses can be doing?
Businesses should be talking proactively about this. They should be getting their staff trained. Cyber Wardens is free. It's accessible. We're rolling it out as we speak. It does not take a long period of time, but it's about making sure that your entire team has that awareness. It's about making sure we're adopting some of these practices, things like password management, things like verification, things like backing up our software, things that we all probably know inherently that we should be doing, but we often just run out of time or we become complacent.
Luke, great advice. We are out of time, but thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Mark. Cheers.
Let's have a quick check of the weather right now. 27 degrees at Sydney Harbour, 30 degrees in our west. Turning to tomorrow's forecast, more rain forecast for Brisbane, a top of 26. Sunny in 27 in Sydney, slightly warmer in Canberra. 22 the top in Melbourne, Hobart cloudy and 20 degrees. A sunny 25 for Adelaide, Perth a top of 30. A wet day forecast for Darwin.